What is going on, everybody? This is the final day, day 12 of the 12 Days of Christmas Horror. And it's actually not... I'm filming this in advance, of course. I'm actually filming this on my birthday. Guys, you remember when I said that I picked a couple of good movies to finish the review series on? Well, this is not the movie that I originally intended to end with. I could not get that movie to play. It's being a pain in the ass for some reason. And my DVD copy of it didn't want to play, and I couldn't find it anywhere else to watch it. So, I decided to do a Creepshow holiday special from 2020, directed by Greg Nicotero, starring Adam Pally as Robert and Anna Camp as Irene. A man who thinks he turns into a werewolf and kills people at night goes looking for help, and he finds a support group for werepeople, people that turn into different kinds of animals. He ends up finding a lot more than he bargained for when he finds out that Santa Claus is actually a werehunter and goes after people like him and kills them and has been doing so for centuries. And he enlists all the volunteer Santas in his army of helpers. Oh, the horror! The movie starts with a rectal exam. Oh, God! Let me tell you how painful that can be. Man, you never had one of those before. I'm telling you right now, that is not a pleasant experience. I had no cons for this. It has a short runtime, only about 46 minutes, but I did really enjoy it. Now, some of you might say, well, that doesn't sound like a movie. Well, it is or it isn't. I really don't care. It is a good fucking film, and as I said, it was a last-minute change. Maybe next year I'll do the one I'm was planning on doing, or maybe I'll do it before then. I don't know. My first pro is the writing, the story. I really enjoyed it. It is a funny film. It is a gory film. It is a smartly written film, even though it's a bit of a ludicrous film. I had a lot of fun with this movie. I like the way they utilize the comic book panels. Now, in all the Creepshow movies, they use the comic book transitions. Well, in this one, they didn't just use it as a transition. They actually used it to show some of the action scenes, and I really did enjoy that. I thought it was a cool way of bringing the Creepshow look around and kind of advancing it in from what we've seen in the past. Something I thought was just really funny is one of the fuckers turns into a Ninja Turtle, pretty much. He basically turns into a Ninja Turtle. This is a fun film, guys. I did enjoy this one a lot. I like the way that the creeper is put into the movie. I like the way that it's done. Even though it is a single story, it still feels like the anthology Creepshow feel. And last but not least, the gore in it is a lot of fun. Now, in my opinion, they do throw an unnecessary love angle in there. But it kind of makes for some good humor, so it's cool. I will have the ranking coming up next. I hope you enjoy it. I hope you've enjoyed this 12 Days of Christmas. Big ups to my brother, Horrific Nightmares JM, who started the 12 Days of Christmas Horror. And big props to everybody who went along for the ride, everybody that did reviews for all 12 days, and everybody who's watched, everybody who's viewed, everybody who's enjoyed it. Those of you that haven't, go back and watch all the reviews. There's a lot of them. They're awesome. And they were all a lot of fun. Everybody did a really good job. Guys, this movie is weird, it is ludicrous, and it is damn entertaining. And I'm going to end this 12 Days of Christmas the same way the Creeper does at the end of this movie. In the panel, he tells everybody, and I'm going to tell everybody, hope you have a great day, a happy Christmas, and happy horror days. Peace.